Hello everyone, my name is Azzurro Stardust, your host as always, and welcome back to Let's Play Turn Investigations Blind. In the last part, we were cross-examining Larry Butts, the worst witness in the history of witnesses. Or at least in the history of Ace Attorney. I don't know if there really has been a worse witness, in my opinion. I don't know, if you guys can think of one, I guess let me know, because Larry's pretty bad. But then again, he's designed that way, so I guess he's pretty good for what he does. So you think all I wanted to do was go visit Mindy? Well, I dressed up as Santa and climbed up to the chimney, but the smoke was really thick. I said that completely wrong, with the wrong kind of tone. Well, I dressed up as Santa and climbed to the chimney, but the smoke was really thick. It was a case of mistaken identity, and that mistake made me late for the speech. Then, to top it all off, I became a suspect in a murder. That's what you really meant. But why would I ever put myself through so much humiliation on purpose? I forget what I was doing last. Hey, someone say something! Larry, are you seriously trying to submit this not as a confession but as testimony? So what if I am? Is there something wrong with that? My claim is a claim claiming my claim. Do you have a problem with that? So it was you! You're my stalker! But I should warn you, it doesn't matter what kind of flattery you throw at me. I am the devoted type of woman who's fully focused. Yep, you just keep on bitching, old bag. I'm not gonna even read a word of it. This one's an extra long one. Oh, I'm so inspired! You're such an inconsiderate, cowardly, idiotic, and all-around completely worthless man. I thought I heard something ominous just now, but perhaps it was just my imagination. I believe there is nothing further for me to prove at this point. What do you mean? Of course you've still got something to prove. You still have to show some proof that I was trying to meet up with my Mindy. Proof, you say? Remember, Edgy, everything is evidence in court, right? You mean, evidence is everything in court, Larry. But I understand your point. Yeah, I see, I'm totally pro at this now. Very well, if you wish to see this evidence, then let me show you the last piece of evidence you'll ever wish to see. So you think all I wanted to do was go visit Mindy? Yes! Yes, I did. Well, I've been saying that for a while now. After all, if not for that, then for what other reason did you wish to go down that chimney? You can't say that without any evidence. That's against the rules, Edgy. Heh, thanks for keeping the prosecutor in line for me, Mr. Suspect. I have the evidence, and if you wish to see it that badly, I can introduce you to. Ah, but it's not good to keep them waiting, my subordinate. Hurry and show them already. Lies! All lies, Edgy! Well, if you wish to lie, then by all means continue, because I'm ready to expose your lie at a moment's notice. You won't get the better of me. Now let's see. So you think all I wanted to do was go visit Mindy. What evidence do we have to prove this fact? The embassy guide, the autograph is pointless, the notes, pointless, 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 pointless. What does the note say? Oh, but I can check everything else. Okay, that's what was confusing me. The vines are supported by stakes and are still growing. What does it say again?
Objection!
Yep. I'm all over it! All over it! Larry, don't even think about denying that you have knowledge of this letter.
Hey, why are you showing that thing to me?
Wendy, I'll be descending on you from above tonight, your loving knight. I don't know how you would say that with an accent. Well, isn't that just romantic? But you weren't able to descend on her from above, were you, Mr. Loving Knight?
I have no idea what you're talking about. I don't remember a thing.
You can't pretend to be ignorant. You can pretend to be ignorant all you'd like, but it's written right here. This sort of proves that you are not up to meet the old lady.
but rather that you were attempting to pay Miss Mindy a visit. What part of this letter shows that the person Larry had intended to meet was Mindy? The fact that her name is right there.
Take that!
Larry, I suggest you take up penmanship lessons. That is, if you never wish to experience this level of embarrassment ever again. What the heck? What are you talking about? Speak English! You wrote Mindy so sloppily that it became Wendy to the average eye. Actually, I write really badly, so I was able to read Mindy out of that, like, no problem. Hey, stop picking on me! It's so embarrassing! There, isn't that what childhood friends are for? They're the best, aren't they? For punching. But that will have to wait until we're off this crime scene. Edgy, save me from the scary man! Sure, if you're willing to make amends, starting with your incredibly embarrassing mistake. That wasn't me. Come again? It's a fake. Someone's out to get me, so they made that fake letter. To set me up. Accept your defeat, graciously. But you guys are being so mean.
Hold it!
Penmanship analysis. What's that? What's that? No matter who, all people have certain unique features to their handwriting. Ergo, all you have to do is compare the handwriting in this letter to a sample of yours, and we'll know soon enough who it was that sent the letter. I'll never write another thing in my life. You don't have to, Larry, because you are the dead. Tsk. It's no use, Mr. Loving Knight, for you've already graciously provided me with a sample of your handwriting. How sloppy it is. This autograph and our mysterious letter. If we compare the handwriting, we'll know the answer to our question soon enough. Confess now, Larry, to your miserable failure. I'm sorry. I did it. It was me causing trouble again. I admit it. You hit the nail right on the head, Edgy. So he finally confesses. I saw the pink princess being carried out in a stretcher and got worried, all right. I wanted to go into Mindy's room, but the doctors wouldn't let me in. So what choice did I have? It was the chimney or bust, Edgy. Your mind jumped from the door to the chimney? What a criminally overactive imagination. Well, at least I was honest and wrote Mindy a letter and stuck it under the door. That way she wouldn't be so shocked when I came down through the chimney. I'm pretty sure anyone would be shocked, even if you sent them a letter that someone would go down a chimney. Except for the fact that the letter was an utter failure at conveying said sentiment. I'm really, really sorry. Larry, you may be a shameful good-for-nothing blight on the face of humanity. However, I always knew that you weren't a killer. I told you to trust me, because at the very least I can attest to that about you. Edgy, you're... We've lost a lot of valuable time because of you. Yeah, take that, Larry. I actually was expecting his testimony to be a lot more complicated and difficult to take apart, like he usually is. But this time it was a rather easy one. So, in any case, I believe we can say that we now know exactly what happened. Mr. Larry Bott sought to climb down the chimney, not for access to the crime scene, but to enter the room of the elderly lady next door. Great job, Mr. Prosecutor. Although I still find it a bit unbelievable that the two of you are friends. Wow, is he actually being nice? But the suspicion on that guy over there isn't completely resolved yet, so don't get any funny ideas about running off, Kay. Oh! Hey, what? Edgy, what does the Wolfman mean when he says I'm not off the hook yet?
He means the murder weapon. Larry, did you forget? There are two layers of suspicion hanging over your head.
That's exactly what I mean. We can't only rely on the words of the suspect, after all. We may have figured out where he was and what he was doing all night, but the blood-stained samurai sword that was left at the crime scene, as long as there is no satisfactory explanation for that, the wolf will refuse to ease up on his bite. Edgy, that guy, he looks like he's serious about taking a bite of me.
I'm well aware, and you should be as well, that this upcoming battle will be crucial.
Thanks to the cooperation of our lovely bumbler, I've been dealt a very nice hand and a sweet trump card. Looks like we're about to enter the final bout. Now, Mr. Prosecutor, let's see what you've got.
I can easily point out the contradiction in the supposed murder weapon. But the real problem for me is figuring out what the real murder weapon is. This will be a high stakes gamble. But this is one game I can't afford to lose.
It's too bad you're not Phoenix Wright, who's never lost a poker game in 7 years.
Anyways, hold on a second.
Oh, it's everywhere. You probably heard what I just opened.
I could probably hear it fizzing.
Wow, that did pop open.
No, it's not Dr. Pepper. I wish it was. Even though we do have some, I'm saving it.
Anyways, why Larry? I was the one who found the body of the victim to mask two. Beside him was the samurai sword, glittering red and offering up the scent of blood. It was supposed to be the Steel Samurai's dressing room, but I found it here instead. Plus, I found the murder weapon's owner, the suspect Larry Butts, in here too.
So, there's an obvious isn't it a bit far-fetched to accuse someone simply on the basis of ownership?
But this owner wanted to sneak out of the onto the crime scene. I think that's plenty to go on, don't you?
If you're alluding to his reason for being by the chimney, we've already established that.
Hold on there, Mr. Prosecutor. You two are longtime friends, right? Who's to say you didn't fabricate the evidence to give him an alibi?
You're accusing me of fabricating evidence? Face it, Edgeworth, you're just like the target for blame. Like, this is the third time now you've been blamed for at least assisting in the murder.
You think I can believe anything you produce? Forging evidence is all you prosecutors do.
This man has some serious issues with prosecutors.
But come on, I can't think up something as complicated as that, right, Edgy?
Larry, I can agree because I know you and your personality well. However, Agent Lang knows nothing about you, or me for that matter. I sense his hatred for my entire profession emanating from his entire being. But Edgeworth, if he knew you and everything you've done in the past, he'd probably hate you even more.
Meaning that the only way I can prove Larry's innocence is to present irrefutable evidence.
Rebuttal. Why, Larry?
Okay, I'm going to check up on the murder weapon, because I actually have not checked up on that yet. It's thought to be what killed Will, because we don't know. Wait a second, I have a question about this then. I guess, well, it's hollow. The samurai spear is hollow. So, hold on, can we, like, examine this? No. Because who's to say that that's not hollow? I guess it being hollow wouldn't change much, though. Maybe, I don't know. Okay, we already know that the alabaster knife was what was, I think. Yeah, it's this. We can actually examine this. I don't know what I'm doing anymore, so I'm just gonna look through the evidence just so I have a vague idea. Anything interesting in this picture besides the statue move? Nope. Wait a minute, hold on, I'm gonna check. The knife set gets caught in there. Huh. Can't really see it now, so we'll just continue. Okay. Beside him, the samurai sword. Let's press on that.
Excuse me, but glittering red and offering up the scent of blood?
Do I have to spell it out for you? I mean the sight and smell of blood, of course. And according to the test, the blood on the sword belongs to the victim. The sword was made to only be used on stage, so it's not sharp. But it's pretty weighty. It's certainly heavy enough to beat someone to death with it. Which leads me to suspect that the victim was beaten to death with the sword.
Beaten to death, huh?
This last statement is too important to just let it slip by. Besides him, the samurai sword covered in the victim's blood. Wait, did that? I suspect he beat the victim to death with that thing. Does that make sense? Is there anything else you could beat someone to death with?
No.
You certainly can't beat them to death with samurai dogs, let me tell you that. Let's press on this.
About this samurai sword, have you received a report from the forensics yet?
They confirm that the blood on the sword belongs to the victim.
Alright, but have they confirmed that the outline of his wound is consistent with the weapon?
Tell me something, do you see the dead body right there in front of you? So if they were conducting the autopsy right now, shouldn't that body...
Oh, that's hilarious, because it digs their own grave with a flaw
later in the game, or sorry, before this. Remember when we got that autopsy report from Bad, and right now he's saying that this shouldn't the game writers don't know what they're doing, do they? At least not with the autopsy report thing. Either that or a different team wrote the fourth case of this game. I have no idea what to say for that, but that's ridiculous that they actually pointed out the problem here. I suppose so. I guess they must still be investigating this room. Meaning that it's possible he doesn't know about that piece of evidence's true nature. So, then I present the spear? Do I present the spear? I don't see how that would help, but let's present the spear.
Objection!
Yeah! I am all over it just by knowing how Edgeworth thinks. Do you know what this is, Agent Lang? Heh, it's a long spear, right? We used those a lot in my country a long time ago. Piercing, mowing people down. Spears are the weapon of heroes throughout history. It's the next most effective weapon after the whip. Ha ha! I think the whip is in a slightly different category. So what's your point? Are you going to tell me that the spear is the real weapon? No, I simply want you to take a look at this section here. The way it's bent. Precisely. Apparently, a certain troublemaker hit it against a wall in this embassy earlier. And as you can see, as you can clearly see, the insides of the steel samurai's weapons are hollow. In other words, they're replicas that aren't strong enough to deliver a damaging blow. Let alone the multiple strikes necessary to bludgeon someone to death. And yet, there's not even a dent in the samurai sword. How do you explain that?
Yeah.
You know, his freakout is awesome. I can give him that.
Oh yeah, the sword and the spear are made of the same stuff, so they bend easily. But I wish they'd make them out of better stuff, because the spear got bent. I wasn't able to do my special early summer rain jab move. Man, I got such an earful from the director of the play for not doing it in the show. The Steel Samurai's special move was changed tonight because of him. Apparently, Edgeworth knows stuff.
Ouch! That's more than enough of your whiny whimpering. Now, back on the topic of the spear.
Yes, let's return to the real topic of discussion. This is where the real gamble begins. I don't have a real strategy, per se. So all I can do for now is let the chips fall where they may.
Using guesswork and taking risks in place of real logic is hardly the Von Karm. Wait a minute. Could have the murder weapon be the statue? Because it was moved. And we don't know why. I'm going to go with guessing the statue. I could be 100% wrong, but that's just something that clicked in my head. Using guesswork in the Von Karm way, it's neither smart nor very clever. Miss Von Karm, as you know, and unlike your father, I am not a genius prosecutor. Plus, I doubt his record of a 40-year win streak will ever be broken. Both perhaps it is for the best if it remains unbroken. For no one should have conceived of the notion to convict all defendants in the first place. What a foolishly foolish statement from a foolish fool who hates to lose. It's the job of a prosecutor to make sure that all defendants are found guilty in court. There is nothing more important in this world than a perfect victory. That may be your opinion, however, I don't believe that's all we are. As a prosecutor, what I pursue is not the perfect victory, but the perfect truth. And if that means that the bridge I must cross will crumble beneath my feet, then let it crumble as I walk towards the truth.
You're good at keeping me entertained, Mr. Prosecutor. But you know, humans are delicate creatures. The slightest bump and we expire. I'd like you to consider, if you will, the possibility that the sword was used in such a way that the attack killed Damask too without bending it.
Oh.
So what do you think of my hypothetical scenario? I think you know what to do here, right? And what you need?
Of course. What I need is evidence even Agent Lang can't refute. This is it. Time to bring this to a close.
Oh, so there's more. I don't get to just present it. Why, Larry, part two. It's possible to use the samurai sword to kill someone. And under these circumstances, it's the only logical conclusion. We searched the embassy top to bottom, but the victim's blood is only on that weapon. So isn't it natural that the suspicion would fall on the owner of said weapon?
I'm going with the statue. How long do you intend to cling on to that preposterous theory?
I'm sorry if you get annoyed by me drinking soda while playing the game, but... Sorry. Oh! Okay, once we get to the beginning of it, I'm gonna stop. As long as I want, because we examined every corner with the walls of the embassy. There's no stone we've left unturned. And we have managed to come up with only one logical conclusion. That the only place inside this embassy with the victim's blood on it is this sword.
You left no stone unturned? Is that a fact?
If you've got something to say, yes, I was right, it is, because they're not allowed to touch it. Then say it in the only way I respect, Mr. Prosecutor.
Yes, of course. In that case, allow me to make it all crystal clear for you.
And in the next part, we're going to be proving what the real murder weapon was, hopefully, and getting to the next continue, please? Please? I'm Azzurro Stardust, your host as always, and I will see you guys then. Saving.